Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys about a few useful methods of the string class. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Hey, welcome back, my good people. In this video, I'm going to explain a few useful methods of the string class. Now, as you know, a string is a reference data type that can be used to store one or more characters, and reference data types have access to some fairly useful methods. Let's begin by creating a string variable called name. String name equals, and let's assign this a value of whatever your name is. So let's type our name variable, dot, and here are all the methods that we have access to. I'll describe and explain a few of the more useful methods that you might be interested in at this level. So let's begin with the equals method. This will compare two strings to see if they are equal. So within the equals method, let's type another string. I'm just going to copy what I have for my name to make this easy. This will return a Boolean value, and we can do something with that Boolean value, such as use it for an if statement or anything else. So I'm going to store the result within a Boolean value. Let's call this result. Boolean result equals name.equals, and then type in a string. And let's display what the result is. So our equals method is going to compare my two strings, my name variable and whatever string is within here. And this will return true. However, it is case sensitive though. If I made the B in my name lowercase, this will now return false. But I could instead use the equals ignore case method. And now, both of these strings, according to my equals ignore case method, is now true. Next on my list is the length method, and just to keep things simple, I'm going to turn this line into a comment, and I am going to create a new variable. So the length method is going to return an integer based on the length of a string. Int result equals name dot length. And this will return a value of 3 because we have 3 letters in my name, but your name might be different. We also have the charAt method. This will return a single character. Char result equals name.charAt. And we list an index if we would like to access the first character in our string. That would be index 0. And the second position would be 1. The third position would be 2. Then you just continue on in that pattern. So the character at index 0 of my name is capital B. Then we have index of. This will return an integer. Int result equals name dot index of. This will find a character and return the index of where the method finds that character. So let's say I would like to find an index of capital B. So this will return the position. And we have a capital B at index 0. If this was O, lowercase o, that is at index 2. We can also check to see if a string is empty. This will return a Boolean value. Boolean result equals name dot is empty. So currently my name is not empty, and this will return false. Now if I got rid of my name and we just have an empty set of quotes here, this will return true because my name variable is now empty. So let me reverse that and move on to the next method. We also have the toUpperCase method. We can change all of the letters in a string all to uppercase. So this will return a string. String result equals name dot to uppercase. Now my name is all uppercase, and there is also to lowercase. Actually, I'm just going to copy most of this, paste it, and change upper to lower. This will change all of the characters in my name all to lowercase, and now the B in my name is now lowercase. We can also trim some empty space before and after the string. String result equals name dot trim. So this will remove all of this empty space that I just added. The trim method will remove all of this empty space before and after my characters that I have. And the last method I have to show you guys is the replace method. This will return a string, and we can replace a character with another within a string, name.replace. And there are two values we need to place within the replace method, an old character and a new character that we want to replace the old character with. Let's say we would like to replace all O's with A's. So this will replace the O in my name with A, and now my name is Bra. Well, guys and gals, that is a few of the more useful string methods, but not all of the methods entirely available to you. If you type in a string variable, type dot, at least with Eclipse, this will prompt an entire list. And you can always read through some of the descriptions to see what some of these methods will do. So those are a few of the more useful string methods. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. Don't be afraid to help me out and smash that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.